Don't tell me the banjo's dead. Oh yes, I've heard the tale. That banjo isn't dead at all. He's caught the Western mail. He has a lot of friends, you know, among the Western men. He wants to look into their eyes and grip their hands again. He longs to spend some quiet nights beneath the western stars and hear the evening wind again among the green villas. So if you tell me banjo's dead, just say that it's a lie. He comes from where they breed him tough, and banjo will not die. They say that Clancy sent him word he's at the overflow, with many more old mates of his who knew him long ago. There's the man from Snowy River, from Kosciuszko side, who brought the wild mob in alone and showed them how to ride. He's got his mountain pony too, as tough and wiry yet as when he chased the Brumby mob and the colt from Old Regret. Another chap now, what's his name? Oh, he comes from Ironbark. He thought the barber cut his throat, and he didn't cop that lark. All these old mates of his are there, with others on the way. And when he got a call from them, how the hell could Banjo stay? There's Gundy Guy and Saltbush Bill, a rough and rugged pair. I bet there'll be some fun, you know, when Banjo meets them there. Old Trooper Scott is coming too, to represent the force. And Andy Regan, or his ghost, on Father Riley's horse. They're making for the overflow, and when they all arrive, you'll see that Banjo isn't dead, mate, he's very much alive. They'll hold a racing match, of course, you bet your life they will. And there'll be fun with Gundy Guy and tough old Saltbush Bill. Old Pardon will be hard to beat, they say he knows the track. But Swagman perhaps will run him close with Ryan on his back. And near at hand, old Rio Grande is sure to make a claim, with Bold McPherson riding hard, a horseman grim and game. I see them racing neck and neck, and as they near the post, old Falcon Bella hits the front with Regan or his ghost. Old Falcon Bella hits the front, but as they pass the judge, a yell goes up for Mongrel Grey, the poor old station drudge, who with the boy strapped on his back, through swirling flood and foam, swam bravely through the pitch black night to bring the youngster home. Old Mongrel Grey has beat 'em all, an honest horse and true, and Clancy's glad to see him win, and so is Banjo too. Then glasses clink and healths are drunk, and many a tale is told of roving days and roving days that never will grow old. Yes, the seasons come, the seasons go, and little here abides. But good old Banjo will not die as long as Clancy rides. As long as bushmen love a horse or wild swans swing on by. As long as there's a Southern Cross, the Banjo will not die. So send the joyous news abroad through hut and shearing shed, and tell the bushman not to grieve, for Banjo is not dead. Yes, tell the bushman not to grieve, for Banjo is not dead.